Thank you very much, Council President. I will be voting no on the bill. People have a First Amendment right to free speech, and that includes the right to protest. And in our country today, there are so many people who are protesting. They have very, very different views, and there are many frustrated and angry people. And they have every right to march, to rally, to protest. However, that ends when they break the law. They cannot break the law and violate other people's rights. And we are coming into a discussion now about what is a peaceful protest. Because I feel it's peaceful, it should be peaceful. That's a very subjective view. And what that does is to create a selective enforcement problem. And that's what we have seen. One of the things that has occurred is that people have gone out into the middle of the highway and blocked other people's travel. They may be blocking 4 or 5 cars, but that can set back for 2 or 3 miles. And every one of those people in those vehicles have something to do. And their opinions may be absolutely in support of the protesters, but that's not the point. The protesters went out into the highway, blocked the traffic indiscriminately of anyone's needs and concerns, and that's illegal and unlawful. And they were told to leave, and they did not leave. Now, I don't tell them to leave. I'm a councilman. We have city workers who are charged with that responsibility, and they are law enforcement, and it is their job to go onto the highways for the safety of those protesters, for the safety of the people in the vehicles, and to ensure that no people in the vehicle get out of their cars or run into the protesters or pull out their guns. That's why the police are there. And they have a level of tools. And one of the tools that they used after it was approved by the managing director and his body of executives in conjunction with the police commanders and the commanders on the street was to deploy tear gas. And from what I've seen, and I was not there, they deployed a canister that caused the group of people to move in another direction, but then they stopped and they would not get off the highway. And then the police deployed more canisters. So they were warned and told, and they were given every opportunity to leave the highway, and they did not. And that deployment of tear gas is for the safety of them, the police, and every motorist that is on that highway. Now, the result of which is that a deputy police commissioner demoted himself, managing director resigned, the mayor apologized, and one of the police officers is being, I believe, prosecuted. That is a chilling effect. We're going to find out what should or should not have happened. But what I'm saying is that how do the police respond when they are being told by our city to go out and quell riots, violent protests? And by the way, I live near 52nd Street. That place was lit up. Fires, violence, assaults, cars being smashed into each other. And so the police have a tool to disperse large groups of people, hundreds, thousands of people, and that's called tear gas. It is a non-lethal force if you get out of the way of the floating gas. And yes, it will float into people's homes. Better their homes have tear gas than be set on fire. There's no perfect situation when people will not comply. The idea that someone can come to your home, stand on your porch with 50 people and protest you, you may feel frightened. You may feel afraid. You may call the police. They have no right to violate the law. Criminal trespass is a violation, and the reason it's a violation, it makes people want to react. And we do not want people reacting. This chilling effect, this endangerment of police and others. Listen, I agree 100%, and I have not met one police officer who did not agree about the issues involving George Floyd. We all saw it on the video, and the need for reforms. But taking away tools and then saying that we get to pick and choose which activity is a First Amendment activity. What about a group that we disagree with occupying the highway? What about their protest? Do we use tear gas on them because they won't leave? If people perceive that the police will not do their job because they are told not to respond, not to arrest, and we have looters shooting looters, people take matters into their own hands, as they are doing now with skyrocketing gun purchases. The largest demographic of people purchasing guns are African-American women. Why is that? People do not feel safe. They will defend themselves if they continue to believe that the police are being hampered, being blamed to the extent that the police will not respond. And what I'm saying is, one, while there is not much wrong with this bill on its face, it does raise the question, what is a peaceful activity? What is a First Amendment activity? Who's making that decision? And ultimately, what happens when the police choose not to respond, or the people wrongfully, rightfully believe they have to take matters into their own hands? Anyway, that is the reason I will vote no on this bill. Thank you.